Pro Tools SE ships with an extensive collection of audio loops that you can use to create your own compositions. Using these loops is a lot of fun. Now here's a session that I created earlier. We've got a drum track, a piano, and a bass. Each of these tracks have their own mix controls. Now I'll bring down the drums and balance the piano and the bass. Nice. So I want to add an audio drum loop on the stereo track that was already part of the session when I created it. Now you can tell it's a stereo track because it's got twin LED meters. If I hold down Control, Windows key and Alt and then click the meters, I can make them nice and wide. So two LEDs for left and right as opposed to one LED for a mono track. Okay, let's put a loop right here. I'm going to come up to the top of the edit window and open the loop window by clicking this button. Then I'll come down and open up the factory content folder. Here you'll find a nice variety of loops all under different genres, and I'm looking for some drums. I'm going to use this one, and when you drag it out of the loop window onto a mono track, nothing happens as opposed to a stereo track. You can see the outline appear. Just drop it where you want it and the waveform overview will calculate. Let's take a listen. That sounds good. So I want to add a different loop, say just here. And again, I'll use the loop window to audition the file. I like this one. It's simple and laid back, but I'm going to drop it into position anyway. Let's take a listen from midway through the last loop. Now, a couple of those drum hits are a little bit late, round about here. But I'll fix that later. For now, I just want to add a drum fill between these two loops to add some dynamics to my session. Now this is where the small waveform in the loop window comes in handy. It lets you eyeball when something different is about to happen, like a drum fill. Now I'm going to drag it into the timeline just a little bit later than where I need it. I'm going to use this area to work with that region. Now you can do a couple of different things here. You could select the portion of audio that you don't want and then simply delete it. Let me undo that. Or you could choose the part that you do want to keep and then press Ctrl T or Command T on the Mac to trim that region to the selection. Very nice. Or you could select what you want, right click, and then choose Separate. Now you've split the one region into two independent regions. Now just delete the one you don't want. I'm going to press Escape repeatedly to cycle around the different tools until I get back to the hand tool. Then I'm going to pick up the drum fill and drop it right into position. And there it is. But I can see a glitch, and let me just zoom in on that. There it is, a transient from the preceding loop. Again, I'll cycle my tools by pressing Escape until I get to the Trim tool, or Trimmer. I'll turn off Snap to Grid, and you can see how the Trim tool changes depending on which side of the edit you're on. I want to trim back the transient, like that, and then fill the gap by trimming the front part of our drum fill. Nice. Let's zoom back out all the way, hit Return, and then play. Now don't forget to explore all of the loop content that comes with Pro Tools SE, because you're bound to find something to inspire you.